Hi there. Here's three ideas for procrastination. Procrastination, it's that thing that we don't want to do. It's that person we don't want to speak to because it's going to be awkward, or we're fearful of their reaction, or we want to go in the loft to clear out our loft and make it clearer, or we know there's stuff up there that we'll need. And we put it off and put it off. You know, there's lots of reasons why we procrastinate. And one of the reasons is we feel fearful. We feel fearful of the outcome. We feel like we're perfectionists. You know, we want to get the timing right or whatever. But there's never any right time. The right time is now. And just think how great you'll feel when you've done it. So my first takeaway today for dealing with procrastination is, the first thing is I suggest write it down what you want to do. Even write it down the night before you intend to do it, write it down. And then it sort of like percolates inside yourself overnight. And then, you know, you're getting the ball rolling for it to happen. So yeah, so write it down. Write it down. That's the first thing. That's the first thing I'd say to do with procrastination. And yet the second thing I'd say is, you know, It's in your vibration. You're thinking about it all the time. It's at the back of your mind, and it is affecting you. You know, when you want something done and it's not getting done, it's sort of like it sort of takes the edge off everything else. So another way of dealing with procrastination, I'd say, is imagine the result. You know, just really visualize. I'm a big believer in visualizing and imagination, because it gets the universal law of attraction going. So imagine it. Imagine how it when it's done, how you'll feel, and think, oh, you know, and it sort of like makes your vibration clearer. You get clarity and everything like that. So yeah, so imagine the result and really get the feeling place of it. You know, think, oh, it'd be lovely when that loft is clear. You know, or, you know, it'd be great to get them dresses down that I know are up there, but I can't wear them because they're in a load of junk. Or, you know, when I've had a word with that woman about what she said to me, you know, it's playing on my mind. You know, I can do it in an assertive, loving way, and I feel so much better, and, you know, I can't have people talking to me like that. Yeah, just get into the feeling place of it. Okay, so let's say that you've done your thing that you've been procrastinating about. The third thing I'd say is celebrate when it's complete. Celebrate when it's complete, and then that will start the momentum for other things that you're procrastinating about. You know, so I think, yes, I did it. I'm invincible. I can do anything. You know, this thing that I've been thinking about for years, I've done it. Or, you know, it's just like giving you more clarity and more feelings of invincibility. So yeah, they're my three takeaways today for dealing with procrastination. I procrastinate, everybody procrastinates, it's just one of life's things, you know. So you're not the only one that procrastinates, and I hope this has helped a little bit. Thank you very much, and bye for now. Thanks for listening. Thank you.